When you build things in Angular, you'll probably end up wanting or needing to add animations and transitions to parts of your UI. One very common one is a slide in or slide out animation where an item transitions from a hidden to a visible state. And since this is something that you're likely going to need at some point, I figured that I'd show you how to create one. So that's what we're going to do in this video. Before we can create and add our slide animation, we need to include the animations module in our application. In order to do this, we need to add the providers array to our Bootstrap application function. Then we need to include the provide animations function within this array. Okay, now we can add animations. So I've already created a basic component for this example. Right now, it's super simple. And if we look at the code for this component, we'll see just how simple it is. All we have is a single visible Boolean signal that's initialized to false. If we switch the template, we just have a div, which is the box that we see in the middle of the screen. And then we have the button that toggles the value of the visible signal when clicked. So what we're going to do is use this value to toggle the slide animation we're going to create. This box will start outside of the left side of the viewport and then slide in when the value switches to true. So let's switch back to the TS. Okay, to add animations, we need to use the animations array in the component metadata. Within this array, we need to add a trigger function from the animations module. Then we need to give this trigger a name. Let's call it slide. Now we're going to animate using our visible value, so it will have two states. One will be false for when it's hidden, and the other will be true for when it's visible. To create these states, we'll use the state function from the animations module. Then we need to provide the state as a string for the value that will trigger the state. Let's start with the false or hidden state. We're using a value of false because we'll be binding this animation using the visible signal. So when it's false, it will trigger the state. Okay, next, we need to add the style that we want the box to have when it's in this hidden state. We do this with the style function from the animations module. This function requires a style object. Now, if we think about what we want here, we want the box to start outside of the viewport to the left and then animate to its current location. To do this, we'll want to use a negative x translation value. Let's go with a value of negative 200%. Okay, now let's add our visible state. For this, we'll use a value of true. Then we'll translate to a 0x value. Okay, so that's our hidden and visible states. The last part of the animation is to transition between the two states. We do this with the transition function from the animations module. The first value that this function needs is an expression representing the states that we want to transition between as a string. So we can add false, and then to denote animating between two states, we'll add an arrow pointing in two directions. Then we add true. This expression states that we want to transition from a state of false to true and from a state of true to false. So basically, whenever the value changes, we want the transition to run. Okay, now we can animate this transition with the animate function from the animations module. For this function, we provide a duration and optionally an easing function as a string. Let's go with a duration of 0.15 seconds, so pretty fast. And let's add an easing function of ease in out. Okay, at this point, we've created the animation. All we need to do now is add the animation to our box element in the template. So let's switch to the template. Now we'll bind the animation trigger on the div element here. And to use our animation, we use the at symbol followed by the trigger name. Then we'll bind this to the value of our visible signal. Okay, that should be everything we need for the animation to run. So let's save and see how it works. Okay, so now to start out, we don't see the box. So it appears like our hidden state is being applied correctly. Now let's click the button. Nice, now the box slides in from the left. And if we click the button again, it animates back to the hidden state. So that's pretty cool, right? Now, what if we wanted to animate in a different direction? Like if we want the box to animate in from the right side instead? Well, this is pretty easy. We just need to switch the translate value on our hidden false state from a negative to a positive value. There. Now let's save and see how it looks. Let's click the button. Nice. Now it's animating in from the right. And when we click it again, it animates back to the right. What about if we want to animate down from the top? Well, we just need to update the translate value on our hidden state again. Let's go with 0 for the x value this time, and then a value of -300% for the y value. Okay, let's save and take another look. Let's click the button. There, now it slides in from the top. And that was pretty easy, right? Now you know how to create a basic sliding animation from any direction. But you don't actually have to create this if you don't want to. I've found that there are quite a few animation concepts that I use pretty often when building Angular applications, and I don't want to recreate them over and over again. So to cut down on this work, I'm creating an installable Angular library called NGX Bootjack Bounce, where I'll be creating and sharing several of these animations. So instead, you can install and use it if you want. Now, at the moment, I only have a slide animation in it, but hopefully by the time you're watching this video, there's more available. To use this library, you can install it in your Angular app using this command. Now let's look at how to use it. Here I have our same component with no animations again. Now, I've already installed the library in this project, so I'm ready to use the animations within it. To create the same animation we just built in the first half of this video, I can add the BTJ slide state animation. Then I just need to go into the template. Here, I can bind this animation to the visible property again. There, now let's save. Okay, so it's starting off hidden again. If I click the button, now it slides in. And when I click it again, it slides out. So that's even easier, right? But with the animation we built, we could easily change the direction. How would we do the same thing here? Well, if we want to customize this animation, we can provide some custom configuration using animation params. The params available are start X, start Y, start opacity, start scale, and duration. So let's add some custom configuration. To pass params to our animation, we need to convert this to an object. Then we'll pass a value to this object based on our visible signal. This will trigger the appropriate state for the animation when the value changes. Next, we can add the params object. Now we can set our params. Let's animate in from the right with a start X value of 200%. And then let's add a start opacity of 0 and a start scale of 0.7. Also, let's slow it down with a duration of 3 seconds. Okay, now let's save and see how it looks. Let's click the button. There, now it slides in really slow from the right. We can even switch from a state-based animation to an enter-leave animation if the element you need to animate is added and removed from the DOM conditionally. To illustrate this, I've switched the logic in the component around so that the box is now conditionally added when the visible signal is true. Now let's switch to the TS and add the animation for this. This time we'll add the BTJ slide enter leave animation. Now we can switch to the template. This time we won't need to bind the animation. We can just add the trigger to the div. That's it. Let's save again. Now let's click the button. And there we go. Even though this item is entering and leaving the DOM physically, it's still transitioning. And on top of that, with this library, you didn't really need to add much yourself in order to do this. Also, all of the same params, start X, start Y, start opacity, start scale, and duration, are available with this enter leave animation too, so you can change it to suit your needs. So now you know how to create a basic slide animation, and you know how to make it slide in and out from all different directions. And if you don't want to create one yourself, you can use my library. Okay, I guess that's all for now. I hope you found this tutorial helpful, and if you did, check out my channel for more videos on animations and on various other topics and features within Angular. Until next time, thanks for watching.